excuse the quality, but this is a genuine 78 revs per minute vinyl blues from 1935. It's by part-time prostitute, full-time blues performer, and tough-as-old-boots, tobacco-chewing, guitar-playing, outrageous Memphis Minnie, as bluesman Johnny Shines remembers. Any man fool with Minnie, she'd go for them right away. Guitar, pocket knife, pistol, anything she got her hands on, she'd use. Memphis Minnie used to be a hellcat. Minnie's being recorded here by Lester Melrose in Chicago. She's using the name Texas Tessie, performing You Wrecked My Happy Home. It's a bit scratchy, but let's have a listen. Memphis Minnie was just one of many blues artists from across America who Lester Melrose recorded in Chicago in the 1920s, 30s and 40s. Here's another. This is Mississippi bluesman Tommy McClellan, recorded by Melrose in 1941. Lester Melrose nearly got himself killed by rednecks going south to Mississippi to take McClellan back to Chicago to record. "They don't call me a white man down there," Melrose told his friend Big Bill Brunsey. "They call me a Yankee." "What does that mean, Bill?" "I told you, they don't like a white man from the north out on their farm," Bill Brunsey told Lester Melrose. "Or anywhere they have 500 or 600 Negroes working. I told you, you might get hurt."
Get hurt,
Melrose spluttered to Bill. "Hell, they nearly killed me, and would have done, if I hadn't run like hell." "So Lester Melrose used to send me down south," said Brunsey, "all the time, after artists. He never went down south ever again."
"She wants me back again, cause I'm cross-cut so. Baby, drive me cross you low. I'll cut your wood so easy, can't help but say I do. Yeah. Not paying that one time. Yeah. I'm a cross cut so. Baby, drive me cross you low. Cut your wood so easy. Can't help but say I do.
Tommy McClellan with Crosscut Saw Blues. This was made famous by my own personal blues guitar hero, Albert King, in 1966. I'm sure you'll recognize this intro. The great Albert King with Crosscut Saw, backed by, would you believe, Booker T and the MGs. While King retained the Tommy McClellan lyrics, except for two verses replaced by guitar solos, he changed the arrangement to the Afro-Cuban style of guitar rhythm Albert had enjoyed success with earlier. But back to Lester Melrose and his unparalleled contribution to Chicago blues. This is another Lester Melrose produced track, Champion Jack Dupree's Junkers Blues from 1940. But Melrose didn't just discover, produce and record all these blues artists in Chicago. He created a unique sound known as the Lester Melrose sound. Let's hear a bit more.
I don't use no reefer. I be knocked out with that engine wine. 6 months and no, and no.
Like Memphis Slim's Grinder Man Blues last time, this is yet another 1930s and 40s song about drugs. But Lester Morris' Chicago recordings, including Grinder Man Blues and champion Jack Dupree here's Junker Blues, couldn't be more organized.
With my reefers in my hand, upstep the sergeant took my reefers out my hand.
In his Chicago studio, Lester Melrose pioneered new assembly line recording techniques, which sped up production. He initiated using session players to back his artists, often the same session players, guys like Big Bill Brunzi, the teenage white guitarist George Barnes, and Washboard Sam, who we'll hear right now. This is Back Door by Washboard Sam, produced again in Chicago by Lester Melrose in 1937.
Tell me, mama, who's that in a while ago? Oh, tell me, mama, who's that in a while ago? Yes, when I come in, who's that when I was that back door?
The Melrose sound, which we're hearing now, was a precursor or forerunner to the later distinctive session sounds, like the Motown sound, forged in Detroit, or the Muscle Shoals sound, which coincidentally comes from near the father of the blues, W.C. Handy's 1873 birthplace in Alabama.
Who's that one out that back door? This is something I never seen before. You broke down my bed, got a pallet on my floor. Now tell me, mama, who's that here a while ago? Yeah, when I come in, woo, that went out that back door.
The Lester Melrose sound was a unique combination of blues, old school vaudeville, and the new style big band swing rhythms, which were coming into vogue in the years leading up to World War II. It totally dominated the Chicago blues scene during the 1930s and 40s, and Washboard Sam, with the hypnotic rhythm of his magic washboard, was one of the most popular Chicago musicians of all.
I had his window nailed down, he couldn't get through. Had his hat in his hand, and his underwear too. So tell me, baby, before I get so. Yeah, when I come in, whoo, that went out that back door.
Real name Robert Brown from Arkansas, Washboard Sam is thought to be Big Bill Brunzi's half-brother, and Bill himself used to joke about that.
Now tell me, mama, who's that here a while ago? Yeah, when I come in, who's that one out that back?
On this 1937 track, however, blues took second billing. It was actually marketed as a foxtrot, subtitled Washboard Sam, Blues Singer with Washboard Band. I'm Paul Merry, and this was part four of the Lester Melrose story, the man many experts regard as the founder of Chicago blues. Look out for next time, and for part five.